Hello, John Talley here with PartZilla.com, and welcome to the next installment on our 2017 Yamaha Raptor 700 build. Today, we're going to be focused on getting the head torqued down, the timing, and then setting the valve lash. Now, as far as the parts go, I've got them laid out and they're ready to get installed. In the previous video, we had already lapped the valves, installed the rocker arms, as well as the camshaft. So all that's done and ready to go. Now, if you need help gathering up the parts for your build, why don't you check the link in the description below, and that'll give you the exact shopping list for this particular engine. Now, if yours is a little bit different, if you would visit our website at PartZilla.com, it's really easy to use. Start off by picking the manufacturer and then drill down to whatever part or list of parts that you need for your machine. If you're still having trouble, then give us a call. That's what we're here for, and we can guide you to the correct parts for your application. The special tools, really going to be a short list this time, but let's go take a peek at them. As always, a good torque wrench. You do need to pick up a set of feeler gauges, and if you want to make your life a whole lot easier, go ahead and pick up one of these little adjustment tools. It is so easy to use, as you will see. Well, now that we've got our parts and special tools assembled, we can head over and get this little project done. So let's go. Let's start by giving the cylinder and the head surfaces just one more cleaning to make sure we've got a good surface for that new head gasket to adhere to. Let's go ahead and get in our front chain guide. Make sure the bottom of it engages with that slot toward the front of the cylinder. Now the piston looks to be at top dead center, but maybe a tick below. Let's go ahead and pull our inspection plugs. Let's get our dowels in place, and we can go ahead and set the gasket on, and then we're going to verify that the crank is indeed at top dead center. As predicted, she's a little bit off. I can't see that eye mark, and that's what we're looking for. And no, you don't need this large of a wrench to turn the engine over. But I do use one this big just to where it will hold it in place via gravity. There it is. We'll let that just hold it right there. We've got our surfaces cleaned up. This is prepped, top dead center. Ready to say goodbye to our logo. Let's go ahead and close this thing up. Be careful with these machined edges. They're like razor blades. So when you grab it, make sure you've got a firm grip. Otherwise, it's going to make you regret it. All right, now just for safety's sake, let's go ahead and put in those two 5mm Allens on this side. We'll just snug them down for the time being, and we'll come back and torque them later. Let's make sure we can bring that chain up, because it would be a shame to get all this torque down and then not to be able to get that chain back up. So we're just going to lay it over the camshaft assembly for the time being. Now, let's go ahead and get those head bolts in. What I'm going to do here is get a light coating of grease on the bottom of the washer, as well as in between the bolt itself and the washer, because when we torque it down, we want this to turn freely and not distort the torque value that we're trying to get on this bolt as far as stretching it. Next, let's put a little bit of oil on the threads before we drop them in. The torque values for this are going to be 25 for the top ones, 27 for these two at the bottom, and 7.2 for the ones on the end. And the sequence goes like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Not a lot of torque on these compared to other engines. When you're doing this, don't hold the socket or the extension because that'll skew the torque. Next is getting the gear on. So let's go ahead and grab our chain. Get it over our gear. And what we're trying to do is make sure it's going to be lined up to where this mark is pointing straight up. And you want to pull up on this part of the chain. It needs to be taut. Not very hard, because you don't want to move your crankshaft. Right, basically just get it in there, and then we'll start walking the chain to get the alignment. There we go. That may be it. Yep. Now, move our camera around to this dowels line up. Get on there. There you go. And I believe that's going to be it, guys, because I've got it pulled to where it's showing tension there. We just need to go back, make sure that didn't move, and we're still dead on the mark. So that should be it. Next, we're just going to get these two bolts installed, but as usual, I'm going to put some Loctite on there just to make sure that they don't go anywhere. Do be careful here and not drop these into the crankcase. Now, I do not want to torque them yet. I've just got them in finger tight. Reason being is I don't have any tension on the chain, and it will be really easy for it to jump a tooth. So let's go ahead and get our tensioner installed. Then we'll come back and torque these down. We've already got the tensioner retracted back. We've actually got the spring and the bolt and then the crush washer sitting on the table. So we're going to go ahead and get this in. And it only goes in one way. Let's get these torqued to 7.2. Now we can go ahead and put in the spring, that outer bolt. Don't forget this little guy right there. And you'll hear it as I push down, it'll click as it's going toward the tensioner. Now let's just get that torque down. And its torque value is 14. So that's good to go. Let's go ahead and put together our thermostat and the housing and then get our oil pipe in place. Thermostat goes in with that hole facing up. Next, you've got the housing. Don't forget your O-ring. Let's get these torqued to 7.2. And then this guy has a copper washer because that is your bleed bolt. All right, next, let's get our temp sensor on. Don't forget its washer as well. And it has a value of 13 foot-pounds. Let's get that oil pipe in place. All right, banjo bolt, then you've got the washer top and bottom. Same thing for the lower section. And then this one support bolt that goes up front. Now each one of the banjo bolts gets 14 foot-pounds and then just 7.2 on that front bolt. Next, since we're up there, let's go ahead and get that little valve installed. It's basically three different pieces. Have this, I guess you call it a filter of some type. This little guy goes in first. Then you've actually got this little one-way reed valve. Lets gas pressure go out, but it won't let it come back in. All right, this does not have an O-ring because it actually seals against this rubber surface. Then just a couple of bolts. Let's get these torqued to 7.2. All right, guys, time to set our valve lash. Now, to do this, you want the engine to be cold, and I don't think this one can get much colder than it is right now. And what we're looking for on the intake is 0.1 millimeters, and on the exhaust, 0.18. And now, if you've got a little bit of a variance there, you can go from 0.09 to 0.11 on the intake, and the same thing on the exhaust. You can go to 0.17 to 0.19. But we're going to aim for that right in the middle, and we're going to start with the intake at 0.1 millimeters. And as I mentioned earlier, it's probably one of the best tools out there for doing this particular procedure. I'm going to slide the gauge up under there, and we're going to bring it down. And what you're looking for here is you don't want to crush it, but you just want to have a little bit of stiction on it to where it takes just a little bit of effort to pull it through. So not grabbing it to where you can't move it and actually denting it. You just want to barely have it make contact with it and just a little bit of pressure, but you can still move it. Now, once you've got it set, you hold that top section still, and then you bring the bottom section in to actually tighten that lock nut without allowing that top section to move, the actual adjustment part. I mean, trying to do this with a pair of needle nose pliers and a wrench, it's almost impossible. This, well worth the money. All right, that's one side done. Let's go for the other. All right, it's got it. Make sure it's not too tight. That should do. Let's go ahead and tighten that in. Easy. Next, let's find our 0.18, and then we'll take care of the exhaust. All right, it's got it. Let's back off a tick. I can still move it. So easy. That simple. So we've got our valve lash set. Let's go ahead and get these other covers on and start with the camshaft cover. I actually made a mistake down here. These bolts go up there. The black ones come down here. We're just going to replace them one at a time. Those other ones, they too long for up there. So all of these bolts for the front and rear covers for the valve access, as well as this camshaft cover, they're all going to be 7.2. The covers are actually the same from the front to the back, so doesn't matter which one goes where. Next, let's get our access covers on for the crankshaft and the timing mark. Let's put a little bit of anti-seize on our plug, because this is so thin, you wouldn't want to have that break off. This set to 9.4. Well, all right, guys, there you have it. The last of 528 parts, which it took to build this 2017 Raptor 700 engine. Well, listen, if you have any questions or comments, just leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. If you like what you see, why don't you hit that subscribe button? That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. Listen, we just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Partzilla, and we will see you in the next video. Have a great day.